want to make gin. So, we're here at Artisan Monday Night Suppers, Cypher Winery, Christian. Why are you a part of this whole thing, man? What's the big deal here? Why do you want to be a part of it?
Pasa food scene's amazing. And, you know, the brothers.
Brothers Kobayashi are a big part of the pasta food scene.
Brothers, I mean, K.
You know, it's an amazing scene. You know, I mean, I love Paso because the food bar has gotten so high, and it's allowed us in the wine game to come and meet their challenge. And these guys do a great thing in the winter. That, you know, business is slow or whatnot, so we all get together and we do these fun, crazy little parties.
And no other restaurant
absolutely
does
rock
this.
It. We rock it. We do something. We all get together. We pair wines. We pair food. Everybody comes out and does a big family style feast. And that's actually one of the more real deals in town. So cool.
Enough of Artisan. What were you pouring here, and what are you most stoked about on the Cypher Winery scene?
Well, Cypher's just starting to come to the surface and just come out. We released a few wines through the tasting room, but this was literally one of our first events where we've come out and paired it all. And
right.
It's been fun because they're real crazy food wines. I mean, I gotta tell you, I've made my big California wines, but these are my stinking French wines. they're a lot of fun. And they've got great acid, crazy, wild, the dark and brooding flavors. The whites are white, are bright and crisp with great
the
acid.
Whites are so white.
The whites are wet. Or what?
That rosé was bitching.
Yeah, the rosé is very Spanish in style. You know, not a screaming alcohol right. bomb, but gorgeous fruit, great acidity.
Right.
Just dances, it's got weight. Something more, you know, it's like when you need something more than a white wine, just to like take you someplace. You know?
And I got to hear you talk a little bit about that move better, because I was stoked on it, but you're super happy with it.
It's kind of my dirty fetish. I call it the dirty sex. Because you got all these great wines, you got Grenache and Syrah and whatnot in these Rhone blends, and they're all pretty, they're all nice, they're all wonderful, but Mourvèdre is the tragic hero. It's the ugly story. It's the thing that makes you cry. It was Old Yeller when he died. It was all Mourvèdre's fault.
Yeah,
and,
right.
But bottom line is that, you know, we've realized that here in Paso and at Rocks that we can make really dark, scary, brooding wines.
And you're on fire!
So we've
good night,
some,
lovely lady.
We will be
so
you get it.
So
we
made
some
amazing, dirty French ones. We are the French imposters. And I love it.
Yeah.
Just because I think the terroir of Paso is really starting to shine. We've got vine age now,
right?
Where we've got these great
yeah.
clones planted. We've got the right sites planted. We've got great people doing all the right farming practices. And the concentration and the high-end elements there. So now with the vine age, you're starting to see, you know, college students going to college instead of little kids going.
That's
trying to make them go to college. And we're making real serious wines, and you're getting it in the character of the wines. The depth of flavor, the layers of flavor, there's just so much more there. There was like a dark and brooding story a couple of years ago. Well, now we'll make you weep.
Right.
So that's kind of where it is. So the Mourvèdre is right now camp, and I think that's going to be my new siren song.
The Mourvèdre was, I was stunned by that, and the rosé, I would say most of all, for sure. Doing good stuff, man.
Well, if we had a shitload of oysters, I bet we could have a field day with the Grenache Blanc.
I'm sure. And dude, you're doing good stuff, man. I'm glad to see you out doing your thing, kind of rocking kind of a new winery scene here in Paso. I mean, I know the Four Vines thing was all what it was, but Cypher mm-hmm. things to be,
yeah.
you know, a step
four
up.
Vines,
like,
Four Vines rocks.
Yeah.
And, we did a great job with it. We created a hell of a winery and just some amazing things. I learned a lot in my years there. But now this is me. I don't have to be the bull in the china shop
right.
anymore. Now it's all about grace and eloquence and making screaming
well,
ridiculous wines. And this is my wife.
And she is lovely.
This is why I do it. One, the marketing behind it all, too, so you'll see a photo of the label and then the back of the front label, too. They're killing it as usual. So,
yeah,
Artisan, it was Windrose Farm, Cypher Winery, all in the Monday Night Suppers. Welcome
yeah.
to Paso.
Hootenanny. Woo!